Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about an exciting new method for refining impure silver, such as coins, cutlery, or old jewelry, using an electrolytic cell. But the best part? We're not using nitric acid or silver nitrate, which are commonly used in traditional methods. Instead, we found a more accessible and cost-effective alternative, sulfamic acid. Let's dive in. While I'm preparing the electrolyte, which is simply water and sulfamic acid, I'll explain the process in more detail. First, let's quickly review how a standard electrolytic cell works for refining silver. In the traditional setup, silver nitrate is used as the electrolyte, and the impure silver object, whether it's a coin or an old spoon, is placed at the anode or the positive side of the cell. When we apply an electric current, silver from the impure object dissolves into the electrolyte, while pure silver begins to deposit at the cathode, the negative side. But why does only silver deposit and not other metals like copper? It's all about the reduction potential of each metal. Silver has a higher reduction potential compared to metals like copper, meaning it will preferentially deposit on the cathode, while copper and other impurities either remain in solution or fall away as sludge. This is how we get pure silver at the cathode in the traditional process. Now, the issue with the classic method is that it relies on nitric acid and silver nitrate. These chemicals can be expensive, hard to find, and let's be honest, not the friendliest to handle. Nitric acid in particular is quite corrosive and needs to be handled with care. So, what if we could refine silver without needing those chemicals? That's where this new process comes in. We found a method described in an old patent that allows us to refine silver using sulfamic acid as the electrolyte instead of silver nitrate. Sulfamic acid is much more affordable, easier to obtain, and safer to handle than nitric acid. Here's how it works. Just like before, the impure silver object is placed at the anode. We isolate it in a tube, ended with a cloth to catch any impurities or unwanted metals that may be released. Sulfamic acid serves as the electrolyte, conducting the electric current between the anode and the cathode. When the current is applied, silver ions are still dissolved from the anode and migrate toward the cathode, where they deposit as pure silver. Since copper and other metals have lower reduction potentials, they either remain in solution or get trapped in the cloth at the anode. The result? Clean pure silver at the cathode without needing any silver nitrate or nitric acid. For the cathode, we're using a simple graphite bar. Graphite is a great choice for this process because it's inert, meaning it won't react with the electrolyte or the silver we are refining. I've also set my power supply to 3 volts, which is a safe and effective voltage of silver refining. I have limited the current as well, to avoid any issues like a short circuit that could cause problems during the process. Keeping the current under control ensures that the electrolysis runs smoothly without overheating or damaging the equipment. Once everything is set up, we can start the electrolysis and then we'll let it run for several hours. Over time, we'll see silver start to deposit on the graphite cathode. At first, the silver deposit is pretty small, but as time goes on, it grows steadily. As the electrolysis progresses, you'll notice a couple of things happening. First, the silver object at the anode will begin to refine and slowly dissolve into the electrolyte. At the same time, the solution itself will start to take on a slight blue tint. This is likely due to small amounts of copper ions being released from the anode, as copper impurities dissolve into the solution. One interesting thing you'll see during this process is how the silver deposit on the cathode changes over time. At the beginning, the deposit looks dark, almost black. When we finally turn off the power, something interesting happens. the silver deposit starts to turn into a more familiar, shiny silver color. I'm not entirely sure why, but if any of you have more experience with this, I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments. Feel free to share your theories or any insights. Once we're done with the electrolysis, it's time to harvest the pure silver. The deposit on the cathode is collected, but before we can use it, we need to clean it up. To do that, I'm going to filter the silver deposit using a funnel and a filter paper. This step is important because we want to rinse the silver thoroughly, washing away any remaining traces of sulfamic acid or other salts that may have formed during the process. After rinsing the silver several times to ensure it's clean, we can let it dry. Once dried, we're left with pure, refined silver that's ready for further use. And now, let's take a look at the final results. After several hours of electrolysis, filtering and drying, here's the pure silver I was able to obtain. If you enjoyed this video, or if you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave a comment below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more experiments and content like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.